just been in an experience for the first time with you folks here, sitting, looking at the left eye of many of you in turn, while you were looking at my left eye. And this very simple process resulted in a sense of stillness and presence and ease that is rare, and particularly rare to experience in a group. I have experienced it in solitary group meditation. However, this happened quite quickly, easily, and in a way perhaps more related to the ordinary stuff of life, and particularly in the stages where words were put in, whatever words came up, or motion, or even powerfully words that we thought were reflective of the group, not simply our own consciousness. Altogether, a remarkable couple of hours. Good fun.
The first two times I felt like my heart was opening so much. And I was left with that wonderful feeling, but I was told by somebody in the group that it gets even greater. So this is why I'm back again. And they're right. This time it was different. It was more like a feeling of, I was more conscious of the feeling that everything was merging together and things were filled with light, the light around them. And I just wanted more of it. The one time that I did experience what I think was samadhi was like this experience where everything was just being, and I was part of the being. There was no separate consciousness. And it's so sad to me that this doesn't happen, that we don't that most people don't experience this ever. And even those of us who do, it's just brief moments.
This is my fourth time. And I think every time it's different and a day deeper. I think the longer session is more opportunity to explore and go deeper. Really beautiful. Probably the best thing I've ever done. Is it?
After several days this week, I found myself wanting the world to be like how it felt in this room. I felt myself missing that. I made a decision that I want my world. I want to have a world where I will show up. I want to be that. I want to be how it's been today, the last couple hours, more in my life. And I think that can be that can be a gift to other people. And I've been wanting to have a way to feel like I was contributing to the world by doing something. And I think it's more about me just being being, feeling good inside of me. This feels good.
I guess this is about the fifth time I've experienced this, and it did feel quite a bit deeper and more beautiful today. Looking at each other person, it was almost like looking, I could kind of feel I was looking at another aspect of myself, or another, there was another version of myself sitting there, and then I could see that they could kind of see another version of me sitting, of themselves sitting over here. And it, so it was a merging effect quite strongly. And peacefully, and I'm grateful to have had this chance.
After last night's circle, I had a feeling that my brain had been exercised right here. Then when I went home, I meditated before bed, and I had that feeling intensify, and it was a lot of things happened in my head, and it traveled. And then I was basically not sleeping the rest of the night, but just noticing the whole night. So it was very interesting. And I just have the feeling still that I hope there is more, lots more of this.
Maybe I could share a little bit about where this came from. I was playing out in a tree at the age of four, and the branch broke, and I caught a hold of it on my way down, and that threw me under it and came down on top of me. And I was out for about 7 hours, and while I was out for a large amount of that time, there was no body, heart, or mind. There was no thing at all. It's like being nowhere in the night sky with being omnipresent in the night sky without any objects, no planets, no thoughts, no sensations. And yet there was this awakeness, which was fabulous. There was no self, no location. It was dark, and yet it was illuminated by this awakeness, the light of this awakeness, which is indescribable. No word can contain that which has no boundary or limit. And so when I came back into my child's body, 7 hours later, I had been playing Zorro because my grandfather had taken his life when I was two, and my grandmother had taken her life when I was four. And my parents were disturbed, and my mom was crying behind closed doors, and I felt for the first time these two big disconnects. Feeling her pain and her not letting me share it with her, and wanting to share it all with her and be one with her. So I became very curious about, well, what is dividing us? What's keeping me from being one with my mom and my dad, and keeping them from being one with their parents, my mom's parents? You know, what is death? So maybe inadvertently I brought about my own death, and so I could experience it. And in death I found that there was no death, that death is consciousness, formless consciousness. As later, much later, many years later, I found out, as everybody else has said too, for thousands of years, and that as the sages have said, that if we die in life, then when we die physically, we don't die. That's amazing. And so this formless awakeness that normally doesn't get a lot of attention is something so beautiful and so vast and constant and such a resource, perhaps our greatest innate natural resource. More precious than all the oil and gold and tea in China. And so accessible, doesn't cost anything to dig it out of the ground or share it openly with each other. We may imagine that it would, that, you know, if we shared unbroken eye contact and became transparent and ceased to be who we think we are in our imaginings, that we would lose something, when in fact we don't. So the fact that we all here and in humanity, that our entire species can take this step into this love of being, is save my soul. Just to know that it's possible that we don't have to live in conflict. That simply by sharing this common sense, that we can share a collective intelligence, and be so happy every moment, and feel so much joy. Liberation, every moment passing. That's amazing discovery for me. And I feel for us, so many have discovered the same fact. And it's becoming more and more popular. More commonly recognized. Practices like this one are just stepping stones into permanently being awake together as one.